with food prices rising at the fastest rate in 40 years.
But now, a new line of affordable protein is hitting our shelves. This is engineered human meat.
That's right, a protein made from human cells that promises to be cheaper and tastier than any of its competitors.
I'm Greg Wallace.
And I'm off to visit Good Harvest, where a whopping 6 tons of human meat is engineered every day.
That is stunning.
With the promise of cheap meat for all, it may well be the meaty miracle we need to ease the squeeze of the cost of living.
Anyone for human meat?
For the first time, we're going to find out where it comes from, how it's made,
whoa!
And what it tastes like. I couldn't wait to see the mysteries that lay inside. How do you solve the cost of living crisis with engineered human meat? It sounds like magic.
And this is where the magic happens.
The Good Harvest processing plant has been up and running for over 8 months. It contains both industrial and clinical operations on a site the size of 4 football pitches.
Hey, are you Mick?
I certainly am. Pleased to meet you, Greg.
Very good to meet you. I'm here to learn.
Right, come this way and I'll show you how it all works.
I want to see everything.
Oh, you will.
Mick Ross oversees the production line and is in charge of over 60 full-time staff who engineer roughly 50,000 steaks every day.
So come on then, Mick. How on earth do you grow human meat?
I want to introduce you to our nutrient vat.
Hello, nutrient vat, Greg Wise, telepresenter, and your job is?
Well, what its job is, it processes thin slices of tissue in a nutrient-rich mix, which you see here, and then cells start to grow. So over a 24-hour period, these will slowly fuse together into one great big, what we call a cake.
So you're telling me that is human flesh?
Exactly.
But why human meat? Why not animal meat?
That's a very good question. We've got centuries of knowledge of human medicine at our side. We know more about humans than we do about animals. So we've mastered engineering human cells to make these structured flavours and sinews that we expect from the flavours of steaks we eat.
Expect to be feeding the nation with this. You're going to need a lot of donors.
Well, it's well in demand, and we've got a lot of people coming forwards, because the other great thing about it, it's an opportunity to be paid.
Would you ever consider donating yourself?
Yeah, maybe I would. I mean, I may have to. My bills are as high as anybody else's. You know, I've got a young family, I've got a daughter to feed, so...
And would you feed your family human steaks?
Oh, yes, most definitely. Already have.
After the donor's tissue samples are placed in the nutrient vat, they're stimulated with electrodes and left to grow at 40 degrees centigrade at the proving bay.
So, Greg, after a few hours, this is what we're left with.
Whoa! No way! Mate, that's the biggest chunk of meat I've ever seen. I mean, scientifically, that's amazing, but in terms of food, that is stunning.
It is incredible, isn't
it? That is stunning. Look at it.
This 30-kilogram protein cake will be cut into nearly 100 steaks, and it's all been grown from the cells of just one person.
So maybe you'll give me a hand to lift it out. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, that's it.
Whoa, crying out loud.
We're going to take it over onto the resting board. There we go.
Wow. This must be a relatively new process.
It is. I mean, under EU law, we couldn't possibly operate machines like this due to legislation, but thankfully now we're out, we can harvest people and we can pay them for their flesh.
So what happens to this now?
Right, well, this will either be cut into steaks or it'll go off and be processed for sausages, burgers, you name it. You can do anything with it.
Proper space age, isn't it?
It is.
Meets me up, Scotty.
I'd got to grips with the guts of human meat production, but I wanted to know, how does this new protein compare to a real steak? It was time for that all-important taste test. I knew just the chef for the job.
Chef, look at this. Look, I am seriously intrigued. This is a meat I've never seen before. I want to see what the fat content's like. I want to see what the flavour's like. I want you to cook it, because I don't know anybody better.
Hang on a minute. Good Harvest, made by humans from humans?
Yeah, these come from 3 donors in the northeast of England.
Wow. I wonder if that affects the flavour.
You're right. Do donors from the northeast of England have a different flavour and texture to ones from the southeast?
I would have thought so, because it's what we call in French terroir. It's where you were brought up. You are what you eat at the end of the day. And we're going to find out.
For my blind taste test, Michelle would cook up 3 different steaks and we'd work out what sort of person they were grown from.
Ideally, I want it reared outside. I want it looked after, not stressed.
These donors were from the northeast. So what about a beer-fed Geordie?
I don't know. It's very, very difficult to get my head around. This looks quality. So we're just gonna.
You all right? Okay.
I'm gonna put it on the plate. So we just need to let it rest for 5 minutes, and then you can taste it.
Michelle had cooked up a human meat feast of 3 succulent steaks. Now the taste test could begin.
Whoa, beautifully cooked, of course, nicely presented. Should we both try this one first?
Okay. Right, let's go.
These engineered steaks are grown from the cells of human donors who are paid for their flesh. But can we guess which sort of person each steak has been grown from?